any dissent or any protest in those days also was not looked at favorably by the powers, by the government. I was one of those few ones who stood up against emergency. So in that sense, I was against Congress, I was against Indira Gandhi. But because I was against it, I was not made to feel anti-national as today it is being immediately done. On the issue of small thing, what we can call it as a censorship, not allowing somebody to talk, not allowing somebody to express his or her opinion honestly and as freely as one wants to, was not looked at as an anti-national activity. If you don't agree with the government, that doesn't make you anti-national, is where I come from. I have a different way of looking at this. I don't agree with you. And let me express that this is where I differ. I mean, we have been fighting against censorship at both the levels, at state level for censorship against theatre in Maharashtra. I mean, it is so funny that there is a censorship against theatre only in two states, Maharashtra and Gujarat, nowhere else in the country. I mean, as if to say that this Hindi play Kusur, I can go and perform in Delhi without any pre-censorship, but I cannot perform it in Bombay without getting a certification. Now, these are the small issues, but important issues as an artist, and we have been fighting them. We are also fighting in Supreme Court against film censorship.
See, there is no place for dissent, which is very disturbing. And that is our fundamental right. It's nothing to do with which party. It's to do with which establishment. Because the autocratic tendencies are with the establishment. Once you get power, then there is a tendency to have this autocratic rule. And we as a citizen have to have each one right to dissent. So all the small point that he was trying to make there, and in fact it's so sad and ironic that if they had not interrupted, nobody would have even, like 25 people were there, probably they would have just gone home with the whatever he said. But then the issue is so pertinent that artists whose retrospectives and exhibitions were cancelled without any kind of pre-consultation or whatever.
Or any reason.
Yeah, for any reason. They didn't speak out. And Mr. Palekar made a point that this NGMA, I mean, this particular place is sacrosanct for art. And if that place, if you are saying that only government-owned paintings will be shown, local artists' paintings will not be shown, or the dome will be restricted only, you know, to the local artists, rest of the theatre. I mean, why such restrictions? There has to be a public debate. And we as citizens and taxpayers, we have the right to question that. That is a small point he was trying to make, and they wouldn't even let him speak. And that is sad. That is very sad. And it's very ironic that I am fighting against the censorship in Bombay High Court and in Supreme Court. Nonetheless, I had to submit this, my script, to the board to get the certificate so that they can perform. And it's an irony. I mean, because at this point, the law, that is the rule, and I am a law-abiding citizen. So, I did submit it, but I submitted under protest. So, but that's the case. I mean, once, I just really hope, and I'm very sure that we'll win the matter.